You're listening to the audio production of Stuck in Reverse, How to Let God Change Your Direction by Charles Stanley, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Stephen Bowlby.
I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Philippians chapter 3, verses 13 through 14. Introduction. God will change your direction. Most of us know what it feels like to be lost while driving in an unfamiliar city or neighborhood. One moment we're traveling along without any problem. Then suddenly, we're fighting sinking feelings that result from having taken a wrong turn. No matter how hard we try to dismiss the hounding thoughts, the reality cannot be denied. We are on the wrong road, and we are headed in the opposite direction from where we need to be. If we continue, we will be even farther off course. At this point, we have to stop and double-check our map so we can figure out how to turn around and get going in the right direction. We can have the same experience as we travel the road of life. If you feel as though you are lost, or you have been traveling for some time in reverse, I want to assure you that God can change your direction. However, you must be willing to listen for His voice and obey His call. No matter how difficult the challenge may seem, or how dark your sin appears, God loves you, and He wants to guide you to a place of hope and restoration. At one of the toughest junctures of his life, the Apostle Paul wrote, "I do not regard myself as having laid hold of God's goal yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus." Philippians chapter 3, verses 13 through 14. Paul's heart was not set on worldly passions or pleasing a group of people. It was set only on one thing, living for Jesus Christ. He wanted to know the Savior. He refused to allow negative feelings to weigh him down or prevent him from experiencing God's love and grace. He also resisted the pull of this world and its many snares, which were set to spiritually bind and cripple him. There are many people who are emotionally, mentally, and physically stuck because they have believed Satan's age-old lie that says we do not need God. Adam and Eve fell into the same trap. They doubted the Lord's goodness and faithfulness. In doing so, they never experienced the peace and joy that came from having an intimate relationship with the Savior. When you realize you've taken a wrong turn in life, you need to stop and pray. God knows exactly where you are and what it will take to lead you home. He is not embarrassed by your sin or shortcomings, and He openly proclaims His love for you. Confessing your sin to Him opens up a line of communication between you and the Savior that nothing can break. Second, ask Him to forgive you. God will never give up on you. His overarching plan is for you to come to know Him as your Savior and Lord. This is His ultimate will. However, He also has many plans and desires for your life, all of which are incredible and full of His hope for the future. One wrong decision, or even a series of failures, cannot diminish His love for you. He meets you right where you are and gives you a bright new future. Third, ask God to motivate you so that you will begin to go forward by following His roadmap instead of the selfish desires of your heart. He answers prayer, and He is always willing to forgive and restore. Any discipline He allows to touch your life is designed with a loving purpose to teach you how to follow and obey Him. The world may offer temporary happiness, but only God gives abundant joy that lasts an eternity. People who realize they are traveling in reverse usually respond in one of two ways. Either they turn and walk toward the Lord, or they ignore His call and continue traveling in misery and sorrow. You do not have to travel away from God any longer. Right now, you can turn and walk toward the one person who loves you just the way you are. The moment you acknowledge that you have taken the wrong route and that you want your life to change, God moves mightily on your behalf. Isaiah chapter 30, verses 18 through 19. In Joel, he tells us, "I will make up to you for the years that the swarming locust has eaten." Chapter 2, verse 25. "You may have drifted in your devotion to the Lord, but He is waiting for you to return to Him. Or perhaps you've never made a commitment to love and obey Him. My prayer is that this book will be used in your life to encourage you to follow the Savior and begin to spend time with Him in prayer and worship. If you allow God to work, He will restore all that has been lost. It may not be exactly the same, but whatever He gives, it will be more than enough to meet every need you have, to the point of overflowing." Charles F. Stanley. Chapter 1. How did you get here? It was a beautiful day, the kind that seemed perfect in every way. The weather was fantastic, the scenery was beautiful, and the temperature was just right. I had traveled to Oregon on a photography trip. A few days into the venture, I found myself driving on a road built alongside a rambling river with numerous waterfalls. I had gotten up before dawn to have the correct light for the photographs I wanted to take. However, after stopping beside the river, I realized something was not right. The lighting was wrong, and I knew it would be later in the day before it would be exactly what I needed for my photographs. Since I had plenty of time, I decided to look over the map to see what other points of interest were close by. I remembered that Mount Hood was only a few miles away, but could I drive there before the sun was too high? Early in the morning and late in the evening are some of the best times to photograph. This is when the colors are the richest and most inviting. As I suspected, Mount Hood was only a short drive away. However, I needed to get away from the cloister of the river and find a road that would lead me to an area that overlooked the mountain. I also noticed on the map that there was a small lake near the mountain, and I began to imagine taking a photograph of the mountain's reflection in the small glass-like lake. The scene would be quiet, thought-provoking, and most of all, one that would portray the glory of God's majesty. So, I started my car and headed in Mount Hood's direction. I continued along the road until, just as I had imagined, a small, mirror-like lake appeared in the distance. Looming in the background was the image of Mount Hood in all its inescapable wonder. I pulled the car over and parked in a place where I could unload my equipment and set it up. After taking several photos, I walked back to the car, climbed in, and thought that, since the lighting had changed, I would return to the river and finish photographing the stream that had appeared so relaxing earlier. At that moment, a thought passed through my mind urging me to check the gas gauge. To my shock, it was close to empty. I had been completely absorbed in what I was doing, photographing the beautiful scenery and enjoying my surroundings. But now, my mind raced to retrace the route I had taken an hour earlier. Suddenly, I remembered that I had not passed a gas station. Quickly, I grabbed the map and confirmed what I already had thought. The nearest town was miles away, and I did not have enough gas to get there. It appeared I was stuck. God always has the answer we need. Many people spend a great part of their lives living out over and over again what I have just described. They start out living for the Lord, walking step by step beside Him, and then suddenly, they are off running in a different direction, never thinking about the consequences of their actions or their choices. I was miles away from where I was staying, and I realized I needed help. Daylight in a mountainous area can disappear quickly, and I did not want to spend the night in the shadow of Mount Hood. What do you do when you realize you are in the wrong place, stuck in reverse, when you should be moving forward? Many people panic or simply collapse and give up. But God never wants us to do that. His desire is for us to learn to trust Him at all times in all kinds of situations. Immediately I prayed, "Lord, you know my circumstances. You know how far the next gas station is from where I am located. You are totally in control, and I am asking you to send me the help I need." In faith, I turned the key over in the ignition. However, before I could put the car into drive, I heard something that sounded like a very large truck coming in my direction. To my amazement, it was a power company truck. The man driving it pulled into a space right in front of my car. He got out and climbed a nearby utility pole, adjusted something, and came back down. I got out of the car and waited for him, believing that he was the answer to my prayer. Then I walked over to him and asked, "Can you tell me where I can find a gas station?" The man smiled and said, "Sure." He pointed down the road and said, "Go up this road about another quarter of a mile, turn left, and you will see one on your right." Then he said goodbye, climbed back into his truck, and drove away. I got back into my car and thought about what I would have done had he not stopped. More than likely, I would have driven back the way I had come and run out of gas. When we do realize we are in trouble, we want to rush back to a point of safety. God, however, knows the beginning and the end. He knows the right route for us to travel from one point to another. The shortest and fastest way for us to travel is the route He chooses. God has always provided exactly what I needed when I needed it. The right direction. The one thing we must remember is that God is waiting for us to call out to Him so He can work in our circumstances and straighten out the problems we are facing. When our hearts are turned toward Him in severe devotion, He will speak to us and show us the right way to go every time. After filling my gas tank, I headed back in the direction of the river I had driven beside earlier and took some terrific photographs. You may feel as though you are totally out of fuel, or you may feel as though you are traveling backward. Instead of going forward in life, you are either stuck on the side of the road or in reverse. What do you do? How do you pick up the pieces of your shattered life after suffering a deep blow of discouragement? Is there a way out of the storm that seems to have broken over your life? The answer is yes. God knows the surest route for you to take to the closest fueling station. In fact, the distance is usually no more than about 12 to 16 inches, or whatever the distance it is for you to fall to your knees in prayer. When we cry out to God, He always listens and never fails to answer. You may have spent many years living out what you thought were your dreams. What you have found is that they are broken dreams, and you are far, far from home. Through Jesus Christ, there is hope for the future, love enough to last an eternity, and grace enough to cover every sin you have committed. Even if you feel as though your gas tank is completely empty and there is no hope for your future, God still has a plan. And because He loves you with an everlasting love, there is always hope through Jesus Christ. He is the source of your every need. Chapter 2. Making a Wrong Turn. The teenager driving his parents' car began to think about what it would feel like to be able to shift gears. Even though the car had an automatic transmission, he imagined shifting into first gear, then into second, and up into third. Because the gear shift was located on the floorboard between the two front seats, the temptation to continue his game seemed all the more fun. With the radio turned up, he reached down, placed his hand on the gear shift, and gave it another quick pull. However, this time, instead of dropping into a lower forward gear, his hand slipped, and he accidentally put the car into reverse. Even before he could step on the brake, he knew there was a major problem. The lights across the dashboard lit up, and just as the car came to a screeching halt, a loud grinding noise emerged from the area where the transmission was located. As he stepped out of the automobile, the only thing that appeared to be working was the bell-like noise telling him the key was still in the ignition. Not a laughing matter. Some of us may smile and shake our heads in disbelief over a story like this one. However, for some, the scenario is all too real. traveling through life, they barely give God a second thought. Their lives are focused on achieving the things they believe will give them a sense of self-importance, status, and recognition. They feel as though they are moving forward. That is, until they decide to shift into a higher gear and actually drop back into reverse. They find out that they can barely make it through a day without fighting thoughts of failure. What went wrong? A young man once asked me. How did life turn out like this? I was sure I was going to be promoted. Why did God allow me to lose my job? Before we go any further, I want to assure you that no matter what your circumstances, God is aware of your greatest need.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.